So I explain my my technique for the examination of the elbow. We usually begin always from ventral, and ventral we see always the convex humeral shaft, and moving down till we see the flattened and the surface of the elbow. We see the cartilage, the capitulum, and the wavy surface of the anterior part of the joint. We see here the trochlea, the biconcave trochlea, and the cartilage. We have to move a little bit and to tilt a little bit the probe just to see the cartilage completely. Overlying the cartilage, if we move proximal, we see the two recesses, the radial recess and the coronoid recess, usually bigger, and overlying the capsule between the joint and the muscle. As we see, we have also the recess is really very deep, and the overlying between the capsule and the recess, we see the fat pad. If we see?
No, normal findings, right?
Till yet. Overlying, if we go to the arm, we can see the two big bellies, the belly of the biceps and the belly of the brachialis. Yes, the intermuscular space is really not very clear. We have to move both bellies just to check the space between both, and usually in the middle of the belly we can find the muscular cutaneous nerve just going down. And you see how it moves distal, 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 until it goes just lateral to merge and to join the biceps tendon. On the ventral part, the important is the, probably the most important structure is just the biceps tendon. The biceps tendon is really very useful, very easy just to check. We see in the middle of the muscle the internal aponeurosis of the biceps just merging from the lateral, the lateral head, the long head and the short head of the biceps that merge together and form the biceps tendon. It's the easiest way just to get the biceps with the two heads of the biceps, the long and the short. Just to explore the biceps is really very easy, just finding it from the internal aponeurosis in the middle of the belly. Going down, we have to check the biceps. The biceps is then tilting counterclockwise here and going just in the deep. Okay, then we have to be aware of the anisotropy of the biceps. This is one point it could be helpful, because then we can just find the tendon really easy, just making tilting the probe just to see how it becomes anisotropic, and so we can find the tendon perfect. We have to move down, 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 just to see in fully supination the insertion of the tendon in the radial tuberosity. This is the starting point just to find the biceps. If we have a rupture of the biceps, it's really very easy in the short axis, just go moving down till we lose the tendon. This is about 50% of the ruptures are complete ruptures that displace, proximal displace. It's really very easy just to check from proximal to distal in the short axis till we see really the tendon is ruptured, that we see the stump. If we have a partial rupture, we have to be aware, yes, to check it really on the radial tuberosity. The short head and the... The short head is always the distal one. If we move from the biceps, the first attachment of the biceps is the long head, because the long head is attaching proximal and really very deep, and the short is going direct and more distal. Yeah. So we follow our tendon. We follow our tendon just to the attachment to the. And for the long axis, this is really very important just to check the long axis in partial ruptures, because in partial ruptures always, almost always get a tear really at the insertion. And we have to find how many or how much of the insertion is really ruptured. Not at all. Sometimes long, sometimes short. Yes. Insertion. Then we make a oblique coronal view, just trying to get the tendon really very parallel. This is really important because we have to see the tuberosity, all over the tuberosity, just to see the proximal part of the insertion, that is the long one, and the short is the distal one. And from that point, we have to move, flex a little bit, just trying to get the tendon so parallel as possible to the transducer, so you can find all over the insertion of the tendon. You see a little anisotropy here, and we have to check it moving from medial to lateral, just to check the short head and the long head. It's clear? Another, I think it's really important if you try to get a rupture is just to move, to pronate and to supinate, just trying to get the insertion at the tuberosity. Find maneuvers just to see how the tendon moves with the pronation and supination. This dynamic exploration is really very important, because if you get a tear, it is a complete rupture, you don't see any connection between the tendon and the bone. It's clear. And this is mainly the most important and the easiest way just to get the tendon. If we have a rupture, a complete rupture, short axis is enough. For a partial rupture, the rupture is usually at the insertion. We have to be very skilled and in the exploration on the long axis. The long axis and the coming always from medial in this oblique coronal view, because this is the only way we can get the tendon really parallel to the transducer. It's clear? Questions?
Could you cover the median nerve over the pronator crest and the lacerus?
Yes, but we move now medial. Now medial just to explore. It's really important just to see the connection. No. So moving now to medial, we have to check first the big muscle of the brachialis. Overlying the brachialis is the median nerve. Patrick, ¿me quitas el autofocus este? No me da. Está fijo.
Al moverlo un poco se quita. Simplemente te lo pone en medio.
¿Y este no va?
No está la puesta aquí.
Vale.
Ahora te lo pongo.
Vale, nada, no te preocupes. Vale. ¿Con este?
Con este.
Vale. So, moving to medial, we have to check after the artery, the belly of the brachialis, and then the first muscle that appears overlying the median nerve is the pronator. Pronator has two bellies, the humeral belly and the ulnar belly. The biggest is almost 90% of the belly is the humeral head. It covers the median nerve, and then we have to check after more muscles, there's the pronator teres, The next one is the flexor carpi radialis. The next one, he has no palmaris longus, as we see. The next one is the flexor digitorum superficialis, and the last one is the flexor carpi ulnaris. Important structure is the pronator teres. Here we have one head. The second head is between the artery and the median nerve. It's really very, very thin here in this case. If we move to radial, we see the second head of the pronator. This is ulnar head. This one is the ulnar head. It's really very thin. Mm-hmm.
And the median nerve is coming between the
two heads. Here and there. We can go and look after the insertion. If we move the pronator teres, we see the aponeurosis of the pronator teres, just moving to its insertion on the radial head. We see one head of the pronator, the second head of the pronator, the aponeurosis. It's really very thin. We see both aponeuroses just going to insert on the radius. Moving the second one, the flexor carpi radialis, without problems here, usually. The next one is really important just to check, is the flexor digitorum superficialis. Why? Because the median nerve enters just between both bellies, the flexor superficialis and the flexor profundus. This is the sublimis arcade, another place where the nerve can be compressed. It's okay? If we can move down, if we move the muscles, the superficial one, we are now moving the third, moving the second, moving the fourth, and the fifth. Yes, we are superficial. If we go down, we see the flexor digitorum profundus. The big belly is the flexor pollicis longus and the flexor digitorum profundus. Second, the third, fourth, and fifth. We can check it here. Also important is just moving down. This is the place where the anterior interosseous nerve just starts. It's really not so easy to check. If we have to check the interosseous, we have to go to the membrane, because usually it lies with the artery, just deep over the membrane. Here's the pronator quadratus, and overlying over the membrane is the anterior interosseus with the nerve. Usually, we can see how the interosseus sometimes moves proximal just to merge with the median nerve. Here it is. Here it is moving and going to the median. Important is also to check after the flexor pollicis longus. Can you flex? Because sometimes there is another muscle that goes just very close to the median nerve. He has no one. 70% of the population is the ganglion muscle. Yeah? There's another place where the nerve can be compressed. And this is the most important. Going lateral, moving lateral is the probably the medial ventral biceps. The lateral is, so on the lateral part we have to check after three layers. Over the radius, we have the layer of the supinator, yes? Over the supinator is the extensor digitorum communis. Here is the belly of both extensor carpi radialis. It's really very difficult to differentiate both here in the muscle belly, because they are very close. sometimes with pressure you see how the belly of the extensor brevis and the extensor longus can be separate. This is the ponerosis of the extensor radialis longus. And this is the most important structure. This is the deep aponeurosis of the extensor carpi radialis brevis. That is going to merge with the aponeurosis of the extensor digitorum, forming the common tendon. So at the tendon, we see three layers. The layer of the aponeurosis of the supinator, the aponeurosis that merge the deep aponeurosis of the extensor digitorum communis and the deep aponeurosis of the extensor carpi radialis brevis. That is going to build the common tendon. Yeah? Between both, we will see and we can check the ligament. But it's really important here is to know the layers, because we have here one layer that is the muscle belly of the extensor digitorum. If we move to the long axis, we see the belly of the extensor digitorum with the superficial aponeurosis of the extensor digitorum that is going to attach on the most superficial part of the radial epicondyle.
Which create
the entesophyte, usually the entesophyte that we see at the epicondylitis. Underneath, under the muscle, we see the big structure that merges the extensor digitorum communis, the superficial, the deep part of the aponeurosis of the extensor digitorum communis, and the extensor carpi radialis brevis. This is usually the aponeurosis that gives and makes the pain of the patient, that makes this patient pain that goes really down. And then this is a really very strong structures. And underneath is the supinator that is going to merge, overlying the lateral collateral ligament. We see usually here a little crease, a little tubercle, that is the, here to see, this is the frontier, the difference between the insertion of the ligament and insertion of the tendon. Tendon is going from here to here. Yes. This is radial head, and we see the ligament, the proper ligament of the lateral ligament merging with the annular ligament here. And I think this is the radial nerve is easy, but you have only to check between brachialis and brachioradialis, and you see always the radial nerve. Radial nerve with the superficial, with the superficial fascicle and the profundus one. The profundus one is going really in the deep, yes, going to enter into the supinator. Into supinator in the frozen arcade. Between the, we have to check only brachialis, between the brachialis and the brachioradialis, overlying the radial and the capitulum, we see the nerve, the radial nerve, with the two fascicles, with the two main trunks, the medial one and the lateral, the superficial and the profundus. The profundus is just going down and just overlying the radial head, is going between the two parts of the supinator, the superficial and the deep one. And here at the entrance, we can check, this is a main compression place, this is the frozen arcade, and if we check the radial nerve, we have to pronate maximal, just following the nerve with the fascicles of the profundus one, yes, going down, down, down to match with the anterior, with the posterior artery, interosseous artery, where the nerve just convert into the posterior interosseous nerve. Yeah?